In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how I built this front wing by hand, following this specific foil shape. No CNC machine, no fancy equipment, just a copy router I built at home, some carbon fiber, and a little patience. Let's jump in. I started with a design. Honestly, I let ChatGPT do some of the heavy lifting here. It gave me a few NACA profile suggestions and general shape ideas. I kept it simple, a half elliptical wing with a straight trailing edge. No dihedral, no anhedral, which keeps the build way easier. Final specs, span 111 centimeters, chord 15.5, aspect ratio 9.1, area 1351, and the aerofoil was a NACA 63-412. I drew it full size in Google Slides. Yep, Google Slides. So I could print it to scale. And you can also have ChatGPT give you the chord lengths at 10 centimeter intervals. Or just measure from your printout from Google Slides or whatever other program that you use. Now for shaping the wing, I use my home-built copy router. It's basically a Dremel tool with a router bit running on rails and bearings I bought online. It's kind of like a CNC, but obviously powered by hand instead of by code. I grabbed the foil cross-section shapes from airfoiltools.com. Printed them. And glued them onto strips of 3/4 inch poplar wood with CA glue. Now you could just easily make the foil shapes out of wood, as I started to do here, but 3D printing was a lot less work. Then I drew the wing outline and clamped the templates onto the copy router. The goal here is to carve depth guides into the wood, kind of like contour lines on a map, but for your foil. Then I sawed the leading edge square. Sanded the edge square to the guide mark. Planed the top surface. And then I sanded everything down to the guide marks. 60 or 80 grit works. Power tools make life easier, but hand sanding would work also. Before laminating, I glued on the fuselage mount block just a scrap of the same wood. I drilled oversized bolt holes. Taped on one side. And then filled them with epoxy. That seals the wood so it's never exposed to the water. A thin wooden trailing edge would be a nightmare waiting to happen, so I made a solid carbon trailing edge. Six layers of carbon fiber clamped between two taped wood strips. Once cured, I trimmed and sanded it. And then it was ready for the lamination stage. For lamination, I did one side at a time and used the vacuum bag. I used two full layers of carbon over the wing, plus extra reinforcement patches, two extra layers in the middle on the bottom, and four extra layers on the top. Each reinforcement patch was progressively smaller than the previous one. After curing overnight, I pulled off the breather, the release film, and the peel-ply. I used the cut lap method, wrapping the first layer over the leading edge, masking it underneath as a cut guide. the second side, I used a thin blue masking tape under the regular tape so I could sand right down to the until the blue popped through. You can see that here. Next came the hot coat, a thin epoxy layer with black pigment, brushed on both sides. I wet sanded through 400 and 600 grit, filled the pinholes and fish eyes with thickened epoxy, and sanded again. Then I spray painted with automotive paint. wet sanded at 1000 grit, and check the surface. You'll see water bead up before sanding, but after sanding with 1000 grit, it flows into a perfect sheet, so that's a good sign that you get a good flow there. And that's it, one handmade carbon wrap wood core hydrofoil wing ready for the water. If you enjoyed the build, hit like and subscribe, and I'm going to do another video of how it performs. Maybe drop your own DIY foil projects in the comments below. Thanks for watching, we'll see you on the water.